Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for July 21st, 2023. Well, my goodness, we had an interesting day yesterday with the diamonds surging to the upside with good reports from J&J, and we saw some Travelers Insurance really moving to the upside. But the rest of the market was a little bit on the bearish side. So what does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in? Let's buckle up. Let's get ready for the Friday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. Good morning once again, everyone, and thanks so much for being here. I do truly appreciate it. Well, we have kind of an interesting morning shaping up today with futures trying to bounce a little bit higher here this morning. Asia markets last night were kind of mixed. We saw Japan had their inflation actually increase, causing a little bit of concern over there, so kind of a mixed day. And we've got European markets relatively flat this morning, and just a tiny little bit mixed here. So what does that mean for our day? Well, how about we take a look at these charts and see if we can figure out how we might want to approach the market for today. First off, our diamonds, very, very extended in the short term. So many days to the upside here. It's kind of a remarkable situation going on here. We continue to extend this index pretty sharply. And if we look out across here, where could we go? Well, if those bulls continue to find that inspiration to keep buying, you can notice we've got a pretty big resistance right here in this area. So I would watch this area of resistance. We could rally back up and test that area here once again to see if we can push on out. But I would, if they do break that through, well, we're going to be pushing right up, maybe up into this area of the chart, maybe up there around 358. If the bears find inspiration today, well, where are we going to go? Well, I would suggest about the only place of support that we have down here right now that would be logical and it would be painful would be a pullback into that area of the chart. And if that were to fail, then of course we're looking even lower. So it's one of the problems when you have these parabolic type rallies in the market, that over exuberance, when the pullback does occur, it can be pretty substantial and be a bit on the painful side. So be watching for that potential. It could occur at any time. Now, if we look at our SPY, SPY had just a little bit of a pullback, kind of an evening star pattern showing there in the SPY, but you can see we're already trying to gap up here this morning and pump things right back up here. Now that could be just the Friday relief that we've been seeing here recently. So watch that closely. It could also turn into an interesting little pop and drop. Now, if we take a look at where we're going, if the bulls can continue to find inspiration here, first off, let's take a look right in here. Maybe retest those highs of just a couple of days ago, see whether or not we can pop through there. And if we can, then once again, we're probably looking up here for that resistance level in the chart, somewhere around 461. If the bears were to find inspiration here in the market, then I would be looking for some support levels down in this area of the chart. If we can hold there, we're probably in really good shape. This is certainly a very, very bullish chart, even with a pullback. And if the bears push on through there, then we're probably coming down here, and that would likely raise just a little bit of concern. If we take a look at our QQQ, QQQ had the roughest day yesterday with Netflix and Tesla pulling back pretty substantially here. Obviously, breaking down here just a little bit, that's kind of an extreme evening star pattern in the chart. And that's one of the things that happens once again when we overextend a market, when that over exuberance and chasing charts comes into play, that kind of thing can happen. So kind of keep an eye on this. If the bulls find inspiration here and can push back up, well, let's start looking at the top of this candle and maybe that gap fill in there as those upside targets. And then, of course, if they can push on through there, right back to that high. If the bears continue to find inspiration here today, well, then let me suggest that we come down here and we test this support level here in the QQQ. And remember, guys, in these pullbacks, that's all it is. There is nothing here breaking the back of this chart. It's still very bullish, even if we rest or pull back. So I wouldn't panic all that much about it. If we take a look at our IWM, well, IWM also had just a little bit of selling in there, but you can see we're already trying to gap up this morning and trying to pump things back up into the end of the week. If we can find that inspiration to continue, well, I'm going to suggest we retest that resistance high right there, recent highs, in the chart. By the way, I do think it is important that you might want to notice that we're holding, at least right now, we're holding this little downtrend in the chart, so hanging in there. The question would be, if the bears continue to push through, if we were to lose that little downtrend right here, maybe push down into this level, might raise a little bit of concern in the market. But remember, we're still in extremely bullish market condition in these indexes. So let's take a look at our VIX. Our VIX had just a little tiny increase yesterday, so not a major concern here, like fear really came into play. So we're still very low on our VIX. And if we continue to see those bears push, maybe we test some resistance up here. If the bulls bounce back today, maybe we push back down to try and test some of that support here in that chart. Let's take a look at our T21-22. Now, our T21-22 continues to signal a very, very overbought condition. So even with that pullback yesterday in the NASDAQ and the SPY and IWM, we still are holding in a very overbought situation here in the market. We continue to linger up here, and the longer we linger, and this is one of the longest periods I can remember that we have lingered in this overextended condition of the market. So I don't know what that means, but I will tell you that what I've seen in the past when we linger in this over exuberant kind of area of the market for too long, then what we end up doing is having a substantial pullback, and it can be a little bit painful. So make sure you're continuing to raise those stops. Make sure you're thinking about those profits. Remember, next week we're going to go into an FOMC announcement and likely raise rates, and we've got bonds pushing back up already with that jobless claims number yesterday, where claims actually fell. We're going in the wrong direction on that jobs front for the Fed, and we might actually be seeing inflation heating back up when we see oil prices surging back to the upside. So watch that closely here in the market. So if we can find some bullish energy today, just kind of keep in mind, we may not have much room for that upside move. If the bears find inspiration, well, obviously we've got plenty of downside opportunity in the chart. Now, if we take a look at our T21-08, the percentage of stocks above their 40-day moving average, little teeny tiny pullback here yesterday. So nothing in here that is bearish on this pattern. It's still very, very bullish in the chart, except for the fact that we have reached a very overbought condition in the market, where we have stretched the majority of stocks up here so far. In fact, if you look at a lot of charts, you can see there are a lot of parabolic patterns in the market. So when we're up here, we do want to be watching for that possibility of pullback, that it could occur at any time. So kind of keep a close eye on that. About 75% of the stocks above their 40-day moving average. If we look at our T21-07, just a little bit of flattening out there yesterday, not much happened. 60% of the stocks holding above their 200-day, and once again, we're reaching that very frothy condition here in the market, where we're very, very extended. There's nothing bearish showing right here yet, but just that idea that it could occur at any time. If we take a look at our T21-01 continuing to show us that hook over going on here where our breadth is running into that little bit of a problem. And I think it's just simply because we're so overextended in the market, and we might be able to see that possibility of this pullback or even a consolidation expanding here. If not this week, then next week. And by the way, I did when I look at charts like this, I'm usually taking some bearish positions. I didn't take anything aggressively bearish here in because of this T21-22, but I did put on bear call credit spread positions, and the QQQ position ended up just at the end of the day yesterday was up 40%. So you can make some really good money if you recognize the fact that we're either overbought, or when we're down here, we're oversold. There's trades that you can make to really take advantage of that knowledge. So kind of keep in mind, rather than fighting the market condition, let's work with the market condition. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar for today, or excuse me, our economic calendar for today. Our economic calendar, we've got a couple things that we're going to want to be paying attention to, but it's not going to be on the economic calendar. Economic calendar is dead. We've got a Baker Hughes rig count, and that's basically it. Nothing on that calendar to really move us around. And just kind of keep in mind that everyone's going to be thinking next week, we're running into an FOMC announcement, a rate increase. We know that that's likely the case. And we'll want to watch that pretty closely, because there is that little concern about what that means. And of course, we do have those tightening banking standards that are happening. And I don't know if you've been paying attention to what's been happening in the commercial real estate side, but over in Baltimore, we have had our second office tower that being dumped at a 69% discount. We're seeing a lot of commercial real estate problems starting to crop up, and that is putting more and more pressure on the banking system out here. So we'll want to watch those things pretty close. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar, and just realize that this is probably where we're going to get our energy today, is from earnings. First off, we're going to hear from American Express. AXP will be reporting this morning. It looks like we do have that report, and a little bit of a disappointment here this morning looks like coming into play on AXP. This is the pre-market activity after that report, so kind of keep an eye on that. If you were watching last night, ISRG kind of disappointed as well on the healthcare side of things. So yeah, just a little bit where we push these markets so high, it looks like companies are having a little bit difficult time matching some of these high prices in the market, and that's something I've been kind of warning about. If we look on at other reports this morning, we've got AutoNation reporting. A little bit flat here on that one. I'm not sure, honestly, if that report is out. This has been really extended to the upside. You can see just that parabolic move. And now just a little bit flat. CMA reporting this morning. Nice little pop there in Regions, Chimera. Regional Bank moving to the upside, so looking pretty good there on that one. HBAN reporting here this morning. Looks like we're getting a nice little bounce here. Interesting pattern here, nice little head and shoulders type pattern breaking through. Yeah, I'd keep an eye on that one. Here's Regions Financial, also trying to pop up here just a little bit this morning, so watch that one. We've got Roper Industries reporting today, so watch that one. Nice little pop here this morning, breaking through to the upside. And last but not least, we're going to hear from Schlumberger today. Keep an eye on that. Looks like a little bit of resistance coming into play here, a little bit of a pullback. Nothing major here, but we'll want to be keeping a close eye on that. We might want to take a look with AXP reporting. and kind of disappointing. We may want to be keeping an eye on Visa pulling back here, losing some support in the chart. American Express, this is going to be really, really important if we're going to continue to move higher. We're definitely going to need these credit card companies showing showing some good buy support by the consumers. So watch that close. And I do think MasterCard is setting up here for an upside opportunity. Let's take a look at some of the stocks that could be setting up for today. But before we do that, guys, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that subscribe button on YouTube and also click that bell icon when it pops up so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you find these videos to be useful or helpful, if you could do me that favor and click those thumbs up buttons, leave a brief comment, that helps the channel to continue to grow. Thank you so much for those who take the time to do that. I truly appreciate it. And I do want to apologize that yesterday I didn't get a chance to answer those comments. We had a special e-learning yesterday, and I was just kind of tied up and not able to get over there and do that. So I will be back on task here today. Let's take a look at a few charts, and keep in mind, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any security. As a matter of fact, you're going to need to do your own due diligence. Be very, very careful not over trading this market just in case that pullback does occur. Let's take a look at Etsy. Etsy's in an interesting little pattern here. You notice we're breaking this downtrend here in the chart. Nice little W formation, and we're working to build that first higher low here in the chart. I keep kind of an eye on this. If we can pop that resistance right in there and begin that uptrend here in the chart someplace, there might be some opportunity. Now keep in mind, it's going to report on 8.2, and that really could mess things up completely here in that chart. But I think it's worth keeping an eye on it. It may go early here, so worth keeping a close eye on. One of the things that we're going to have to be watching here today is the dollar. The dollar starting to rally up again pretty sharply, and we're seeing those bond yields also increasing. So as the dollar rallies, that's going to have typically a negative effect on a lot of the commodity prices out there that we have kind of been keeping an eye on. But that being said, let's keep an eye on some of the ag areas of the market. MOS continuing to look pretty good in here. This was my price alert on that trade. Nice little pop to the upside. Any rest or pullback in here, I think, sets up an opportunity. If you take a look at CF, big pop. That was my alert right there, that pink line. By the way, anytime you look at my chart and see one of those pink lines, you know that I've set that as an alert, and I use pink because it just sticks out like a sore thumb and everybody can see it. So everyone knows where I've got alerts on my charts. A nice upside move here, breaking through some resistance. Now we need a little bit of a rest or consolidation in here on CF. So wait for that next opportunity in that chart. Take a look at wheat. Boy, wheat had a big pop here just recently, and with the rising dollar, looks like we're going to get a pullback in here. A lot of volatility in this chart, but we do know that Russia is stopping anything coming out of the Ukraine, and Ukraine is a huge supplier of wheat to the world. So watch that closely here. If we can find some kind of an entry into that trade, maybe along this trend, a little rest in there, find that next opportunity to the upside in wheat could be very, very important to be paying attention to. Let's take a look at some of the other stocks out there that I've been keeping an eye on. Starbucks. You see, I've got a little price alert on here. Obviously, resistance level in the chart. Now, it's going to report on 8.1, and that can create some problems for us. But watching for that next opportunity that may pop on through to the upside. Keep a close eye on that. As you guys know, I've talked about Medtronic for quite a while. This had quite a bit of volatility in it, pushing down hard, but boy, yesterday it got busy with the upside move, popping through to the upside. So now that we've broken this downtrend in here, I want to look for that next opportunity into this trade. And why Medtronic? Medtronic is very involved in the AI culture out there, and it has been lagging behind the other AI stocks. So watch that closely if this were to find some buy support in here. Yeah, I'd be interested in maybe picking up some of that. Watch that one closely. Take a look at Lyft. Lyft is also setting up here. Nice little breakthrough of resistance in the chart. Little resting pattern back here. Watch this trend. I think there may be an opportunity coming into that stock. You know, something that's kind of cropping up here and could be a very big deal for the market. UPS showing some bullishness here in the chart, but UPS is involved in a negotiation, and there seems to be a pretty substantial concern that UPS may go in on strike. If UPS goes on strike, that will be a pretty big hit to the economy because of supply chain issues and things like that. So I would watch this closely. Could be something to pay attention to. If they do resolve it, we might see UPS move to the upside sharply. If it doesn't resolve it, well, we could certainly see UPS pulling back pretty substantially, and it may have a negative effect on the overall market itself. Take a look at Kohl's. Kohl's has been doing a really good job here pushing up in this chart coming up out of this bottom. Nice little pattern in here. We've popped up, rested. You can see there was my price alert in the chart, and now pushing on through to the upside. Keep an eye on Kohl's. You could also take a look at the Gap stores. Gap stores also showing nice little patterns in here. If we can pop through that resistance here in the chart, I like patterns like this where we rest back, hold that trend, look for that next opportunity to the upside. So there's a few charts for you to consider today. I want to wish you guys all a fantastic day and a wonderful weekend. Be careful, be safe out there. Remember, a lot of volatility in this market, and we just could see a little bit more selling. If not today, next week, a little bit more pullback might be due just because of the worry of what the Fed might be doing here in the very near future. So let's watch carefully for that. Y'all have a great one, and we'll see you right back here bright and early Monday morning. Wishing you all the best.